Hello students, welcome to another session of geography. This is standard 6 geography and we are trying to understand North America. This is the part 3 session in understanding North America. In the previous two classes, we were trying to understand North America, political divisions, 23 nations, countries and capitals. We focused on physical features like Western Cordilleras, Appalachian Mountains, Central Plains, important rivers and its features. Then in today's session, we are trying to understand case study, lumbering in Canada and at the same time, the lifestyle of lumberjacks in Canada. Okay, now you can see the map here. This is the place where the lumbering activity is carried out. Okay, so the green patch on this North American map, this is your Hudson Bay. The surrounding areas, the green patch is your lumbering activity. This is the taiga region of this particular continent. Okay, before actually understanding the lifestyle of lumberjacks and lumbering as a case study in North America, we'll understand what is lumbering first. Now, what exactly is lumbering? Lumbering is the procedure of systematic cutting and felling of trees, and these trees are made to send with the help of various modes of transport, either roadways using trucks or railways or river streams, and then sent to the sawmills or the pulp mills for the various product preparation. Okay, so this is basically the lumbering activity. Now, when you are talking about lumbering activity, lumbering industry plays an important role. Without the industry, it is not possible for the lumbering activity to get carried out smoothly, because the lumbering activity is providing the logs of wood to the lumbering industry. Okay, now what basically the lumbering industry is doing? It comprises of various industries, which includes the processing of wood. Okay, before processing of wood, a logging of wood, a storehouse of wood is done, and the whole process of lumbering activity includes a number of procedures which we'll try to understand. The wood preservatives and wood pulps or wood products are prepared in the lumbering activity. Canada basically is one of the oldest place which is using this activity as one of the oldest professions, and it has also found its place in Canadian folklore and history. Okay, now when we are talking about lumbering activity, lumbering industry accounts for 4.4% of the national manufacturing unit in North America, but yet it plays an important role in maintaining the economic prosperity, basically for the rural areas and the remote areas. Okay, now when we are talking about the production area, 10% of the world's forest belongs to Canada and it is spread over 397.3 million hectares. Okay, 4/5 of the forest land is covered with coniferous type of forest and mixed type of forest. Now, what are coniferous type of forest? Coniferous type of forest are the forests which are evergreen in nature, which are very tall, huge, conical shaped trees. They have needle shaped leaves and they have waxy coating. It helps in retaining the evergreen nature, mainly because there is less transpiration process. Fine. Then when it belongs to the taiga natural region. Now, taiga natural region is the natural region which is exactly below the tundra natural region. Okay, so this above region is your tundra region and this is your taiga region. The main species which are grown in this particular mixed or coniferous forest is your spruce, poplar and pine type of trees. Okay, now the lumbering activity which has become very prosperous in this region for many hundreds of years is mainly because there are certain factors which is affecting the growth of this industry and the whole activity as a primary sector. So very first thing is the favorable climatic conditions. So the climatic conditions is more like cool weather conditions, which has helped in the growth of these forests, huge, tall, with evergreen nature, strong logs of trees. Then the mountainous terrain at the same time is allowing the soil, mountain soil, which helps in the growth of these forests. Then all these forests which are grown on large scale on its own basically are commercially very important. At the same time, it is having trees which are known as, or these forests are known as pure stand forests. Now, what are pure stand forests? Pure stand forests are those forests wherein you have only one species of tree growing over a large area. For example, if pine is growing, pine grows for a huge areas of hectares, and if poplar is growing, similarly you have only one species of trees which is growing over a huge area. Those forests are known as pure stand forests, which is a exactly opposite meaning of a mixed forest. Then all these lumbering sites are very well connected with the various modes of transport like roadways, railways and the streams which wherein the movement of logs can be carried out. Okay. This particular lumbering activity requires uninterrupted electricity which is available in this region, and all these factors has led to the growth of lumbering industry in Canada. Okay, production and labor. Basically, when we are talking about lumbering activity, there are two main activities. The very first activity is logging, and the next one is log transportation. Logging includes various sub activities. Okay, that includes cutting, felling, skidding, and sorting of logs. And all these activities carried out by people who are known as lumberjacks. These are the specialized workers who are called as lumberjacks, who carry out the activities like cutting, felling, skidding, and sorting of logs. Okay, so this is an image showing the traditional lumberjacks, or this is a very old picture wherein the lumberjacks are having some saws or the instrument which is used manually to cut the trees. So this is a picture wherein there is a modern equipment used which runs more or less on electricity, and it is being used to cut the tree just about few centimeters above the ground. This is another picture showing wherein a group of lumberjacks are cutting the main log. These are known as buckers. We'll try to understand in the coming slides. Okay, first thing is like cutting the tree. Either you do it manually or you use the electric saw like this and then cut it. Then once the tree gets disconnected with the main part of the tree, it starts falling. So that is known as felling of tree. So this is the second process, is the felling of tree. The first process is cutting followed by felling. Okay, then we have skidding. Now what exactly is skidding? Skidding is something wherein all the logs which are made to cut and fell are taken from one place to another. So the whole dragging of these logs or trees with the help of skidders, tractors, or they use sometimes horses, they use some kind of other vehicles, or sometimes at the same time many a times they use helicopters to drag these logs from one place to another. So that process is known as skidding. After the skidding activity, the next activity is sorting of logs. Now what exactly is the meaning of the term sorting of logs? As I said earlier, that along with the coniferous forest, there is a group of mixed forests as well. So when the logs are cut in from the group mixed forest, they are made to sort out to a particular place, and the sorting is done. And these are the images where the sorting of one type of species of trees is done so that they can be sent accordingly to the concerned mills. So this is your sorting of logs. Okay, then when this whole process of cutting, felling, sorting and all this is done, who is involved in this? These are the lumberjacks. But in the lumberjacks, you have people who are known as high riggers. Now, high riggers are the people, they climb the huge tall trees. These trees are many meters in height. So they have this rope which is tied to their waist, and they try to climb to a greater height along with few people, assistants who are going to help them down. They try to cut the upper part of the tree, and they try to cut the branches first, and accordingly, they try to cut the main center part of the log, and then they slowly come down as they keep cutting the logs. Then the remaining people who are at the ground level help them out in cutting the smaller logs, who are known as buckers. Okay, so these are the high riggers who carry out the cutting of the top portion of the tree. Okay, so these are sawers or buckers who later on use that whole log to cut the log into smaller pieces in this shape. Okay, this is the place where the logging of the wood is done, and this is something very close to the industrial area. Now, when the cutting of the logs was done or is being done, basically by the buckers or sawers, they cut it depending on the requirement of the mill. It is mostly 5 meters or for a sawmill and 1.5 meters for a pulp mill. Depending on the requirement, accordingly it is cut, and then accordingly it is sent to those industries. Okay. Now, life of a lumberjack. Basically, when we are talking about lumberjack, it is a male profession. Males prefer this type of profession, and this profession is something which has been there for number of hundreds of years, and people who prefer to be the part of village area or remote areas usually follow this profession. Now this activity, the lumbering activity, is activity which goes on for number of hours of the day, maybe 12 hours, 14 hours. So traditionally lumberjacks would prefer to stay in the lumbering vicinity or areas wherein there were houses which were known as bunk houses or shanties. These were also known as lumber camps. The shanties or bunk houses is a well equipped house which has a kitchen, dining, a foreman's office, a workshop for repair work, and a restroom. Okay. Recently what has happened, there is a lot of mechanization which is used, a lot of machines are used for cutting, declimbing and chopping the trees. So over a period, the requirement of lumberjacks in total number has got shrunk, or it has got reduced, because the machines have been replaced the human beings. Okay. Today many of these lumberjacks prefer to commute from the place of stay to the place of work, and they don't prefer to stay in shanties or bunk houses. Okay. Then this is a bunk house which usually has all the facilities, including your housing, dining, the place for workshop, then the foreman's office and all that. Okay. Then risk of being a lumberjack, or life of lumberjack, how risky it is. It is very risky because the felling of trees can lead to a lot of injuries and deaths. So rate of injury and death is very high as far as lumberjacks are concerned. Then you can very easily get hit by any tree, because there are n number of lumberjacks who are working in this in this area, and any tree coming from any direction can injure you very badly. You can get hit by a wayward tree. Okay, the most common place of injury is the terrain of British Columbia, is mainly because of uneven terrain and the trees having huge dense cover, and it gets fell from any corner, so the injuries here are more. But over a period, new laws and rules and regulations have been laid down so that the life of the lumberjacks can become more safer also. Okay, so that was about the life of lumberjacks. Then we are having transportation of logs. All this cutting activity, or the whole process of cutting and the logs in different sizes is made, the transportation is carried out. This is carried out with the help of trucks, railways and motorways. Then at the same time, there are many streams which are flowing down. Even that is used as a mode of transporting the logs. Okay, logs are bundled together to form rafts, and then they are dispatched in the water. All this process helps the logs from sinking. It prevents the logs from sinking, and then the mills, which are at the low-lying areas, collect these logs in the log ponds, and these log ponds use stoppers which are known as booms. Okay. Then many a times these logs get jammed, and there are a team of howlers who prevent this log jam. So this is an image showing transportation of logs with the help of stream. Now St. Lawrence River and its tributaries provide accessibility for a very fine transportation of these logs from the place of the cutting of log or felling of log areas to the sawmills or pulp mills, and then from there these logs, the processed logs, is sent with the railway line to various market areas. Okay, coming towards the lumber products, what exactly they are producing. Lumber is the main product of logging industry, that is the logs of wood. Then there is something which is known as wood chip, which is a medium sized wood which is produced by cutting or chipping of log. It is used as a fuel or organic mulch. Then we have veneer and plywood, which is used in furniture industry. Then we have round wood, wood pallets, wood based pallets, wood dust and wood pulp. These are other lumber products. Okay. When we are talking about Canada, basically this is the world's largest leading producer of wood, as logs of wood. Then in 2005, 30% of the national produce, and which accounted for 60% of global output. This particular region exports a lot of wood and wood products worldwide. US offers the largest market, okay, followed by European Union, Japan, Australia and South America. Okay. a quick recall about lumbering activity or case study of lumberjacks. Lumberjacks, we were trying to understand the meaning of the term lumberjacks. Then we were checking for the traditional way of lumberjacks, how they were carrying out the lumbering activity, how modern equipments are used to carry out the lumbering activity. Then the lumbering activity includes cutting, felling, sawing, okay, then sending it to the mills. Then we were trying to understand life of lumberjack, how difficult it is. Laws and rules and regulations have been made so that the life is more safer for the lumberjacks in the coming period of time. Then we were trying to understand there is something which is known as bunk house or shanties or a camp area wherein they can rest because the long hours of lumbering activity. Okay, then we are trying to understand how the transportation process about the logs of wood is carried out from the place of cutting till the market area. Okay, thank you.